Even if you've lived in the Kansas City area for quite a while, you may not know much about the National Agricultural Hall of Fame in Bonner Springs. And that's the problem. Attendance is down and there's talk of closing the museum. But in almost the final hour, some people are trying to save it. There's a big meeting set for tonight on the subject. KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney is live at the museum. Micheal?
Larry, we're on the ground to the Ag Hall of Fame here, and some of the people you see behind me here, oh, about three dozen or so, many of them are holding protest signs along the driveway where the Board of Governors are going to arrive at a building for a meeting tonight. Some of these folks are afraid that the board tonight is going to close this museum for good. Now, that's not going to happen, at least not tonight. And the fact that it's not happening, however, does not mean that the Ag Hall's problems are being solved.
Even in the middle of a modern farm belt, not many people know how to make a living like this.
The American public is not aware of where their food comes from as a whole.
How much does that bother you?
That bothers me tremendously.
So the Ag Hall of Fame is in trouble. Attendance is down and interest is faded.
With each succeeding generation, fewer and fewer people are involved in production agriculture.
It is so bad that some members of the board are considering shutting it down.
This is some corn that I have. It's not quite ready yet.
But Steve Tuttle doesn't want that.
It's a National Hall of Fame. It's got a charter by Congress. We feel we can keep it here and we can improve some things expenses-wise.
The area down there is what we call Farmtown USA.
One idea is to sell off some of the 165 acres the hall owns. Most of the ground is not like this. It's undeveloped. And the Wyandotte County Fair Association, which has lost its home, is also interested.
I said, why aren't we talking to the Fair Association? Because it's a perfect fit. They're needing a new home, and it would bring business into the Ag Hall. It would just help both organizations.
So there will be no vote by the board tonight here at the National Agricultural Hall of Fame to close this facility for good. They are going to listen to the County Fair Association and give them some time to make a proposal, and perhaps within several weeks they'll come back with their idea of how to keep this open. So the National Ag Hall of Fame is going to stay open at least for a little while longer. That's the latest out here. Back to you.
Micheal Mahoney live. Thank you very much, Micheal. President Dwight Eisenhower signed the charter for the Ag Hall of Fame in 1960. The first building went up in 1965.